We found a beautiful view of these elephants, and they've come down off of the escarpment. They probably spent the night on top of the escarpment in the villages. And the reason for that is that they need to vary their diet with wood, woody species of plants. And at night, we're finding these elephants coming up onto the escarpment and eating in the forests. And then during the day, coming back to the protection of the reserve. And right now, they're busy drinking some water from that is collected in this sort of seep section. And it's almost, they almost came rushing off of this mountain. I wonder, they didn't have a drink in the whole night, basically. I wonder where they've been. It was interesting to know, you know, the villages start 2 miles from where we are now. And these elephants walk around our tents all the time. And look at that. Look at this female here at the back with the one tusk. She's got an enormous tusk. Just one. The other one is broken off. But that is probably the longest tusked female I've ever seen in my life. And see when she comes now out of... it's very difficult to see there, that angle. But that is a ginormous tusked cow. She'll come out into the open now once they've just slaked that initial thirst. A lot of these elephant cows have babies at the moment, and youngsters as well. Quite nice to see. It's very uncommon not to see elephants with a baby. Tim, you said it's quite unusual or quite weird to see how they smell the water. They definitely do, Tim. Elephants are picky when it comes down to the quality of the water that they like to drink. They like to drink clean water whenever possible. And quite often you'll see elephants walk up and smell the water first and even brush with the tip of their trunk, lightly brush any debris on the top of the water out before drinking. And it's not uncommon for elephant to dig for water even in the presence of surface water. They definitely enjoy a cool, refreshing but clean drink. And unlike almost every other animal out here who will drink whatever water is available to them. You can see that they've just gone down now. Almost all the elephant now at the moment are busy eating. Alice tells me that there's a lot of you that are so happy to see elephants. It's quite nice. Have a look at this elephant that's kneeling down there. He's obviously decided that it's too deep. It's gone down on his knees. How weird. This is the first time I've seen an elephant do that. It is quite endearing, though. This female with a massive tusk is going to come out the back there now. There she goes. Well, that is a noteworthy elephant, I must be honest with you. As soon as you can, see if you can snap a screenshot of her. I'll try and get onto the other side of her. As this sighting sort of passes us, and we'll see if we can get you a nice screenshot of that elephant. It wouldn't surprise me at all if she in fact has a history in this particular reserve. Go forward a little bit. An off-roading zone, which means that I can go off-road here. Let's see if we can get a little bit closer to her and also to her family and see and share a bit more intimacy with them. Elephants, of course, are quite nice to spend close proximity to. They're different to lions. They give you a different feeling. See, now we're at eye level with this elephant there and her young calf, probably no more than 2 or 3 months old, maybe a little bit more than that. Christy, you want to know if elephants have a more difficult time finding food in the winter months? They absolutely do, Christy. In the Kruger National Park in South Africa, Elephant go from eating about 80% grass in the summer to having to eat about 80% woody species of plants in the winter. And of course, you know, having to eat bark and roots and trees and branches, it's more difficult than just shoveling mouthfuls of grass into your face. Ooh, water pouring out of your mouth, delicious. In the Mara, there's no winter. There's a dry season and a wet season. And in the dry season, except for this year, which has had rain almost every single day, I'm sure that the elephants will battle as well, to be honest with you. And it's not uncommon to find elephant in those valleys. So behind that Ellie now, you can see a wooded valley. Elephants spend most of their evenings in those woody valleys. Coming to these marshy areas during the day to eat some grass. But it requires some walking to get up to the top of those hills and into those forests. And so I would say yes, it is more difficult in the winter and in the dry season to find some food, even though there's an abundance of food here. It does become a little bit more difficult, more challenging to get. Not difficult, let's call it a challenge.